गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतानः शृण्वन्नोतिभिः सीदसदनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ओम्। डियर् फ्रेण्ड्स्, वी आर् सीयिङ्ग् दिस् वी जस्ट् कम्प्लीटेड् द 9th श्लोक आफ् 9th अध्याय, दट् ईस् नचमां तानि कर्माणि निबध्नन्ति धनञ्जय उदासीनवदासीनम् असक्तं तेषु कर्मसु। सो दि पायिण्ट् हियर् ईस् दट् गीता आर् लार्ड् कृष्ण ईस् टेलिङ्ग् अबौट् the very delicate connection or the absence of connection between the Brahman and the Jagat. On one hand, we saw in the earlier shlokas, I am the creator of all these things and they are all in me, matsthani sarva bhutani. And in the very next shloka he said, nacha matsthani bhutani, they do not stay in me. So such a paradoxical statement was there in the 5th and 6th shlokas. And then we had a very detailed discussion about that paradox and then how that has been resolved and all that. So similarly, that delicate balance is, we are still continuing examination of that. We are still exploring that particular balance between the Brahman on one hand and the Jagat on the other, where we have to understand what exactly and in what manner is he related. So that is the context. So in that context, in the earlier shloka we read, all these karmani na nibadhananti. What are those karmas? All these prakritim swam avashtabhya visrujami punah punah. That is, I am releasing all these beings. I am creating all these beings with the help of this prakriti or through the medium of prakriti. Prakritim swam avashtabhya vashikrutya. That is, having taken control of this maya and having that as the medium, I am releasing all these things punah punah again and again. Then again, Kalpadav, again, they again come back into me only. So that is what he said. So what is this balance? This balance is through the medium of this Maya. So that is what we are going to see in the next shloka also. This last line of this, earlier Bhashyam, we talked about, Ato anyasyapi kartrutva vimana bhavaha phalasanga bhavasya abandha karanam. So Shankaracharya, he drew a corollary from that earlier statement of Lord Krishna. He said, anybody who gives up that kartrutvabhimana, that notion of doership, if you just give up, and then if you do that, karma yoga, if you are doing your action as part of karma yoga, then you will not be connected or you will not attract the karma phala. So that is what is the corollary he drew from the earlier shloka. That was the last line. And we have to read the next line. Tatra bhutagrama mimam visrujami udasinavad asinam iti cha viruddham uchyate iti tat pariharartham aha. So here again Shankaracharya is taking into consideration one paradoxical statement. Is it okay?
Yes.
One paradoxical statement, that is, bhutagrama mimam visrujami udasinavadasinam. So on one hand he says that I am releasing all this multitude of all these beings. Then again on the other, in the very next line he is saying udasinavadasinam. Udasinaha, one who is transcending. Ut asina, I explained. Ut means above. Asina is seated. That is, one who transcends all these things. This Shuddha, pure consciousness which transcends all the worldly activity. So that is the meaning here. So these two things, how to connect these two or how to understand these two. So that is what we have to see. Udasina vad asina viticha. Viruddha muchyate. That is something contradictory or apparently contradictory or something which is paradoxical that is being told. Tat pariharartamaha, in order to explain that paradox, in order to avoid that particular misunderstanding that there is a contradiction here, then this next shloka is coming. Let us read the shloka. मयाध्यक्षेण प्रकृतिः सूयते सचराचरम् हेतुनानेन कौन्तेय जगद्विपरिवर्तते। सो मया अध्यक्षेण प्रकृतिः सचराचरं जगत् सूयते। प्रकृतिः, यर प्रकृति मीन्स् we should not consider this nature, all this say birds, trees and mountains, valleys, rivers, not that prakruti. Prakruti, the ordinary sense of prakruti is that. In Vedanta, prakruti means maya, that medium of maya, the power which is expressed, that creative power which appears in the supreme Brahman or supreme consciousness is that maya, otherwise called prakruti. Maya, prakruti, ajnanam, avidya, these are almost synonymously used. We have to see the context. We have to see the context and say, here in this particular context, prakruti refers to that maya. Prakrutihi suyate. Suyate means prasuyate. We know the word prasava. Prasava means a female delivering a child. That is prasava. Suyate is the verb. Suyate, prasuyate. Suyate means it generates, it releases. So here only srushti is talked about, but we have to consider sthiti laya also. When one particular thing is expressed, we have to take into consider it is suggestive of the other two factors also. Srushti, sthiti, laya. When srushti is talked about, when you say that jagat is, prakruti is, doing this srushti, you should, it also suggests that the prakruti which is responsible for the sthiti and the laya also. So those things are again suggested here. So suyate. Sacharacharam. Sacharacharam means chara plus achara, that is moving and non-moving. Sacharacharam means inclusive of both moving and non-moving, that is inclusive of sthavara and jangama. So all these things, that is sentient and insentient and sentient. All these things, mayadhyakshena suyate, mayadhyakshena. This mayadhyakshena is not Tritiya Vibhakti. You see, in aham shabda, for this aham shabda, maya. Maya is the Tritiya Vibhakti. Of course, the word is maya Tritiya Vibhakti only, but this is something like Sati Saptami. You know the Sati Saptami. Mayi Sati. When, while I am there. So, something like that. That is Sati Saptami. So, the same Sati Saptami is Sata Tritiya here. Maya Adhyakshena Sata. That is, while I am this Adhyaksha, under my supremacy, or under my supervision, or under my presidency. President, let us preside. That is the correct word. Adhyaksha, normally we also use the same word called president. President of the function. We use the word Adhyaksha. So like that, Maya Adhyakshena, that is why under my presidency, that is the overall meaning. But the literal meaning is while I am the president, so that is the meaning. That is how it has to be taken. Maya Adhyakshena Sata, that is the full word. That is similar to Sati Saptami. It is called Sati Sata Tritiya. This, but the whole thing is in Tritiya. Maya, Tritiya, Adhyakshena also is in Tritiya. Ramena, like Ramena. Then, Maya Adhyakshena Prakrutihi. So, under my presidency or under my supervision, this Prakruti is creating, it is responsible for Srushti, Sthiti, Laya of the whole universe. So, then, Hetuna Anena Kaunteya, Anena Hetuna, by this reason, because of this, He Kaunteya, Jagat, Viparivartate. Jagat means this moving, all thing, the whole universe. Gachati iti jagat, that universe which is always changing, the very nature of it is always changing. Then viparivartate, it keeps on moving and moving, it moves on, let us say. You can note down, it moves on, viparivartate, it just moves on. The whole jagat, which is always in a state of flux, it moves on. So that is the meaning. So let us see the bhashyam. Where is it? Maya. Sarvatah drushimatra swarupena.
Sarvatah drushimatra swarupena.
Avikriyatmana adhyakshena. Mama maya.
Trigunatmika.
Avidyalakshana prakrutihi. Suyate utpadayati. Sacharacharam jagat. Okay. Maya, by me, sarvatah drushimatra swarupena. So here we have to see what is the meaning of maya. So when when the words are from, when Lord Krishna says Maya Aham, he is referring to Supreme Brahma only. Maya Adhyakshena. Then what is the meaning of Maya? Sarvataha Drushimatra Swarupena. Drushimatra. Drushi means?
Drushya.
No, no, not Drushyam. Drushina, Drushi is that is Chetana. Chetana is that is intelligence, consciousness. Drushi is that Druk. You know the word Druk? From that Drushi only, Drushi Dhatu. Drushi Dhatu, Darshane. Drushi Darshane, Drushi Dhatu. That means not merely seeing. We are not talking about the context of seeing only. We are talking about knowing. So in Vedanta, we have seen in the earlier also in Kathopanishad, Bhashya and other places, when you say Prakashayati, Prakasha means not throwing, not putting some torchlight and then say lighting it up. Not like that. It is understanding, knowing. Prakasha means knowing, knowledge. So Drushimatra Swarupena, I who am of the nature of pure consciousness. That is the meaning. Drushimatra Swarupena, Drushi is that consciousness. You can note down Drushimatra Swarupena. Then Avikriyatmana, Avikriyatmana Adhyakshena Mama. So Avikriyatmana, again this consciousness is something which does not undergo any change. Consciousness is one and the same, it is something like Akasha only. Akasha is one and the same. You take one part and you call it Ghata Akasha. You refer to one room and then you refer it to call room Akasha. You refer to some other bigger building and then you say that some Akasha. Then the whole space is something which is one and the same wherever it is. So like that, this Chaitanya may have so many Upadhis. Chaitanya may have some Upadhis and then Upadhi again, it will have different Buddhi Vrutti. So your say mind right now may be seeing something else and my mind may be seeing something else. That is the Antahkarana is the medium. Antahkarana is the Upadhi, not the medium, it is the delimiting factor. That Antahkarana is the delimiting factor on which this Chaitanya is Pratiphalanam. Chaitanya's Pratiphalanam is there. Pratiphalanam is that reflection of that Chaitanya. And then this Buddhi is going and then it is going and seeing some object. And then it is liking that particular object or not liking that particular object. So my Buddhi is constituted in a particular way. Because of the peculiar combination of this sattva, rajas and tamoguna, my buddhi is constituted in a particular way. And then because of the unique combination, not peculiar, unique let us say, because of the unique combination of this sattva, rajas and tamoguna in your buddhi, in your antahkarana, after all, and the whole thing is made of sattva, rajas, tamogunas only. One is made of the grasp aspect of the sattva rajas tamoguna and one is that subtle aspect of that sattva rajas tamoguna. So the mind and the senses are made of the subtle aspect of the sattva rajas tamoguna. So because of this unique combination of these sattva rajas and tamogunas, your buddhi goes to a particular object or that buddhi vrutti. Let us say that buddhi vrutti avachinna chaitanya. In other words, that vrutti also is part of chaitanya only. And then it meets with that Vishayavachinna Chaitanya, the particular object is there, that object also is part of Chaitanya only. So this whole thing is cognized and because of the special unique constitution, you either like it or dislike it. I may like a particular object, you may not like a particular object. But Chaitanya has nothing to do with that. Chaitanya is one and the same, though the Avachinna Chaitanya is liking it and your Avachinna Chaitanya is disliking it. So, is it clear?
Yes.
So Chaitanyam has nothing to do with that. Chaitanya is avikriya. That is the meaning of avikriya. It does not undergo any change. It is something like throwing in a dark room where there are so many objects. You just put light a lamp, and then that lamp shines equally on all these things. So that lamp has no connection with these objects. So like that. So avikriyatmana adhyakshena mama. So that is that adhyakshena mama. Mama Maya Adhyakshena, Mama Maya Trigunatmika Avidyalakshana Prakrutihi. So this Trigunatmika Maya, we have come across this word earlier also. This Prakruti is constituted of these three things called, the three constituents called Sattva, Rajas and Tamoguna. So this we have seen earlier also. So Avidyalakshana Prakrutihi, Avidyalakshana. Avidya is?
Ignorance.
Ignorance. What is ignorance? Ignorance is not a total absence of any knowledge, information. You see one thing as something else, so that is avidya. It is not as though you are totally ignorant of a thing. You have lot of knowledge about that thing, but then what all you know is not what its swarupa. Its swarupa is something, whereas you know the various, analytical details, you have made so much of analysis and you have so much of data, you have filled a lot many, files, let us say computer files with that information about that particular object. But all that particular, that knowledge may not be the real nature of that thing. So that is avidya. Avidya is seeing something as something else. Avidya is not total lack of information. So avidya lakshana prakriti. Why is he using that word? This is basically, the basic idea is it is shuddha chaitanyam only which is seen as everything else. Otherwise you cannot explain the prakriti. Because otherwise you will have to go back to that Sankhya view and then say that this prakriti is also different and purusha is also different and all that. But all the shrutis say and also logic says that there cannot be two things. There can only be one thing. So that is why you are seeing one thing as the other. So that is the meaning here. So trigunatmika avidya lakshana prakrutihi suyate utpadayati sachara acharam jagat. So this sachara achasa achara acharam jagat utpadayati. Then tathasha mantravarnaha. Eko devas sarvabhuteshu gudhaha.
Eko devas sarvabhuteshu gudhaha.
Sarvavyapi sarvabhutantaratma.
Sarvavyapi sarvabhutantaratma.
Karmadhyaksha sarvabhutadhivasaha.
Karmadhyaksha sarvabhutadhivasaha.
Sakshi cheta kevalo nirgunascha.
Sakshi cheta kevalo nirgunascha.
Iti.
Iti.
So this is a line from Shvetashvatara Upanishad. So eko devah sarvabhuteshu gudhaha. So let me just take out the points. So here the point is, there is only one entity, that is this eko devah. There is only one shining thing. Shining means devah, divyate iti devah. That is, it is of the nature of consciousness, it is of the nature of intelligence. And then eko devah, it is in everything and at the same time apart from everything. Sarva bhuteshu, in all the beings, gudha. Gudha means it is so secretly located. What is that secrecy? It is in that buddhi guha. Gudha, guhayam sthitaha. That is guhyam raja vidya raja guhyam. We have seen that word. Guha is that cave only. So what is that cave? Cave is that buddhi guha only. In that buddhi guha only, there is a reflection of this Paramatman, reflection of this Chaitanyam. So this Chaitanya is there in everything. Eko deva sarva bhuteshu gudha. It is there, that reflection of that Chaitanya is in everything. Then sarva vyapi sarva bhutantaratma. This sarva vyapi again we know that is all pervading. Sarva bhutantaratma, that is the essence of everything, that is the essence of all beings. Sarva bhutanam antaha atma. Atma means essence, the self, the very self. That is the thing which knows, the thing which knows, the thing which cognizes everything is that self only. And without that intelligence or chit, without that reflection of chit, no being will be able to cognize. So there will be no difference between the sentient and the insentient. So that is sarva vyapi sarva bhutantaratma. Then karmadhyakshaha. Karmadhyakshaha, what is that meaning of karmadhyaksha? An adhyaksha, of course, in normal functions, the president of the function, of course, he participates in the meeting. But then in the shastra, in the literal sense, adhyaksha is somebody who is above. Adhyaksha is some adhi plus aksha, adhyaksha, he just supervises, he has no participation. That is, karmadhyaksha means he is unaffected by karma. That is the meaning of karmadhyaksha is, that karma phalam, in the, like we saw in the earlier month, earlier shloka, nachamam tani karmani nibadhananti. Karma has that character of, it is binding in nature. You do a particular karma, it gives you some good result or bad result. So this, if that Lord also, if that Brahman also has the karma, if he has got the duty of that creation and if that is seen as a karma, and then because of that karma, he will also be bound by that action. So it is not like that. Karmadhyaksha is, he is unattached by the karma, karma phala. He has nothing to do with this karma phala. So that is the meaning. Karmadhyakshaha. Then what is the next word? Karmadhyaksha. Sarvabhuta adhivasaha. Sarvabhuta adhivasa. Adhivasa is it is something like the substratum, that is the basis, that is the locus of all things. Sarvabhuta adhivasaha. Adhivasaha. Then sakshi cheta kevalo nirgunascha. Sakshi. Sakshi means the sakshi chaitanyam, as we refer to in the case of every being. Sakshi is that illuminator. We have come across two words called, one is the jiva and the other is jiva sakshi. Jiva also is chaitanyam. Jiva sakshi also is chaitanyam or consciousness. What is the difference? Jiva is that avachinna chaitanyam, as though you have got part avachinna chaitanya. Then upahita chaitanya, that which is having part as the upadhi, that which is having antahkaranam as the upadhi, is that jiva sakshi. Upahita is different and avachinna is different. So that way, this sakshi is something which is illuminator. Because of the presence of the sakshi only, that the person, that the jiva is able to see, jiva is able to transact. So that is the meaning here. So this sakshi is that illuminator. Then cheta. Cheta is again the particular chaitanyam. Say here, this commentator writes, darshana kartrutva shankam shata yati cheta iti. So cheta means he is only of the nature of intelligence. There is no darshana kartrutvam. So when you say that there is a sakshi, then sakshi also is seeing something. So there is what is called darshana kartrutvam. That is the act of being a witness. So you may be called to the court. You may be called to court to depose your evidence. So it is not like that. So sakshi here does not mean that there is a darshana kartrutvam here. It is simply in that presence only everything is happening. In the presence of knowledge, or in the only when there is consciousness or say intelligence, everything else is happening, otherwise it will not happen. Again, take the example of a light. In a dark room, you just put on a switch on a torch or light a lamp. So that lamp is illuminating everything, but it has no connection. So that is, it is like that. It is not a sakshi. It is not a sakshi. Of course, in normal Puranas, etc., we refer to Surya, Chandra, all these as sakshis. That is a different sense. We should not take that meaning here. Sakshi, cheta, that darshana kartrutva shankam shatayeti. That is what Anandagiri writes. That means that darshana kartrutvam also is not there. That is, when a witness is there in a normal course, a witness is actually doing the act of seeing and he can be called to a court of law. But here cheta, it is avoided by the use of word cheta, says only by his mere presence things are known. That is the difference. Cheta, kevalaha. The word kevala also means, that is non-dual. Kevala also only means only one and only one. This chaitanyam is the only one thing which is there, and all other things, they take place in it. All actions they take place in it. Then nirgunascha. For nirguna, the meaning given is dharma dharmadi rahityam. Nirguna. You see, the sattva, rajas, tamogunas, they are responsible for various actions. And all these actions, they fall into two categories. One is dharma and one is adharma. And both dharma and adharma bind us. So nirguna is somebody who is above these three gunas. So this dharma and adharma, they do not take place. They do not apply to him. He is beyond that dharma and adharma. So that is why we also read in the Upanishad that a jnani goes beyond this dharma and adharma. Jnani goes beyond dharma and adharma only because he has also gone beyond these three gunas. And whoever can go beyond these three gunas, that is what the Upanishad also says, brahmavid brahmaiva bhavati. One who grows to that level, once you have gone beyond these three gunas, then you are Brahman yourself. So then one person goes beyond that, it is not an intellectual understanding. It is something which it's an internal change which goes on in a person. So it is not an intellectual understanding. It is not as though we read some Gita and Upanishads and then we say, yes, I have become a wise man. It is not like that. There is a need for a total internal transformation. So I should totally get rid of my sattva, rajas and guna, tamas also. First thing to get rid of is tamas. Then gradually, then rajas. And again, sattva also has to disappear. Because sattva again is again binding in nature. because of this sattvic tendency, I may be doing some good deeds, I may be socially useful deeds, that again is binding. So I may be doing, it is not as though I have to totally give up, but then I have to give up that my approach that I am the doer, that kartrutva bhavana has to go, that kartrutva bhavana has to totally disappear. Only then I will be that above, or I will be said to be transcending. I am said to be transcending those three gunas. Only at that time, then you can call yourself a nirguna. So nirguna, the meaning here is dharma dharma bhyam, dharma dharma adi rahityam. That is, there is no dharma and adharma at that level. So you are not touched by those things. Then sakshi kevala cheta kevalo nirgunasya. Then hetuna nimittena anena.
Hetuna nimittena anena.
Adhyakshatvena.
Adhyakshatvena.
Kaunteya.
Kaunteya.
Jagat sacharacharam.
Jagat sacharacharam.
Vyakta vyaktatmakam.
Vyakta vyaktatmakam.
Viparivartate sarvavasthasu.
Viparivartate sarvavasthasu.
So okay. So here hetuna. Hetu means nimitta, reason. Hetuna means nimittena, because of that reason. Anena, what is that reason? Adhyakshatvena, because I am an adhyaksha, as I am the adhyaksha, as I just preside and I do not take part. Just preside and do not take part, because of that reason. He Kaunteya, jagat sacharacharam, the whole moving and non-moving thing, vyakta vyaktatmakam, this whole thing, sometimes it is evident, manifest, sometimes it is not manifest, isn't it? Sometimes this prakriti is manifest and in the laya it is not manifest. So vyakta vyaktatmakam, the meaning is sometimes it is manifest, sometimes it is not manifest. We are not referring to one particular cycle only, isn't it? We are not referring to one particular creation, but there are so many cycles of creation. So in these cycles of creation, the same jagat, sometimes it is vyaktam, sometimes it is avyaktam. When it is avyakta, where is it? It is there in the same maya, in a seed form. That is what we have seen. This all this earlier bhashyam and also in the Upanishad bhashyam, what we have seen is, what is the process of laya, even here in Gita bhashyam we have seen, in the laya, all these beings, they are in the seed form, in that same Brahman. And then this whole baggage of linga sharira will be there. And with that baggage of linga sharira only, the next creation takes place, and in that next creation, one fellow is good, one fellow is bad, one fellow is rich, one fellow is poor, all that disparity takes place. So for all this disparity or inequality in the world, we cannot blame the Brahman. So that is our philosophy. We cannot blame the Brahman or the Lord. Otherwise, we will be accusing the Lord, or you will be accusing the God or Ishvara of being partisan to some fellow, favorable to some fellow, and then angry with somebody else. So you are accusing him of being, not being impartial. So that is it. So vyakta vyaktatmakam viparivartate sarvavasthasu. In all avasthas, in all these avasthas means, in all transactions, in all these things, jagat viparivartate. Then drushikarmatva patti nimittahi. जगतः सर्वा प्रवृत्तिः अहमिदं भोक्ष्ये पश्यामीदं शृणोमीदं सुखमनुभवामि दुःखमनुभवामि तदर्थमिदं करिष्यामि एतदर्थमिदं करिष्यामि इदं ज्ञास्यामि इत्याद्याः Just split it. Okay, when I say he has given several examples, that is aham idam bhokshye, I am eating this, then pashyami idam, I am seeing this, shrunomi idam, I am listening to this, Sukham anubhavami, I am happy, I am enjoying this, I am enjoying this. Then dukham anubhavami, I am unhappy, I am experiencing unhappiness. Then tadartham idam karishyami, I am doing this for that reason. Yetadartham idam karishyami, for this reason I am doing this. So there is a lot of, variety of human activity is being described here. Idam jnasyami, this I will know. Jnasyami is in future. Idam jnasyami ityadyaha avagati nishtaha avagat yavasana eva. Avagati means jnana. Avagati is jnana. We saw in Gita Upanishad Bhashyam also, Gatihi, Avagatireva Gatihi, we saw in one line, one beautiful line, that is, for that, say, Brahmajnani, their Gati, what is the Gati for Brahmajnani? Avagatireva Gatihi, that understanding, that realization, Avagati is realization, understanding. Avagati nishtaha, avagati avasana eva. Avagati nishtaha. That is, all the things which are there taking place in knowledge or in consciousness. Then avagati avasana. They all end in consciousness. So, what all activity you do, it becomes the subject matter for this thing called cognition, for this thing called awareness, for this thing called consciousness. So, suppose I say, I am eating. So, eating is one karma. I will just give some explanation. Eating is one karma which is cognized, which is known. So, which means it is becoming the subject matter which is falling under the same consciousness. Then I am seeing. So, the seeing is an activity. Seeing is a karma. Karma means activity. Seeing is a karma which is becoming a subject, which is becoming the subject matter, or in grammar we call it object. In grammar, subject, object, predicate, we call it, isn't it? So, it is becoming the object for the same drushi karma. Drushi karma means the consciousness. Then when I say I am hearing, hearing is another activity which is again becoming an object under the same consciousness only. So, this is all activities are in knowing only. All activities are in jnanam, all activities are in what is called consciousness. They all become objects to the fact of knowing. They all become objects in the process of knowing. So that let us see the first word of this particular line. Drushikarma, drushikarmatva patti nimittahi jagataha sarva pravruttihi. Pravruttihi. Pravrutti means all action, all human behavior, all human endeavor. That is pravrutti. So sarva pravruttihi. Pravrutti is in Strilinga, so that is why it is said sarva pravruttihi. That is bahuvachanam. Bahuvachanam also. Of course, he has used only one singular only, not bahuvachanam. Sarva pravruttihi, the whole human activity in singular word only he has used. Then what is the reason? How is it described? Drushi karmatva patti nimitta jagata pravruttihi. Drushi karmatva patti. Drushi karma. This is a rather grammatically complicated word. We have to slowly, delicately split it and understand it. Normally, Shankaracharya does not use such language. Only in, what is called Vada Granthas. Vada Grantha means those books which are deliberately constructed in a difficult way. You see, Shankaracharya's job is to make things easy and not make things difficult, isn't it? So, Shankaracharya does not write such harsh, such complicated language. But now and then some phrase suddenly drops in. Whereas, we see some typical Shastra language in Vada Granthas, where you are supposed to defeat your opponent. Where you are supposed, the opponent uses some mighty words. So, you are also supposed to use some mighty words. So, if you go to books like Advaita Siddhi, or there is another book called Khandana Khandakadhyam. So, these books, they contain all the Shastra jargon, which I cannot interpret. I cannot understand also. I have to break my head and then understand that thing slowly and slowly, bit by bit. So, but then Shankaracharya, 90% of the time, he does not use. Maybe sometimes, occasionally, he brings in some jargon because he has to explain the subject. But here, drushi karmatva patya nimitta. You see, drushi is... You can note down also, drushi means jnana kriya, that is the act of knowing. Drushi karmatvam means to be the object for that knowing, that is to be a drushyam. Drushi karmatva means drushyam. You can split and note down, drushi, this is an explanation given by one commentator called Bellamkonda Ramarayakavi, who has written a very great commentary on this Shankara Bhashyam. So, drushi means jnana kriya, that is act of knowing. Then drushi karmatvam, he says, tan nirupita karmatvam means that which is made evident, that karmatvam which is made evident by this knowledge, or that is it becoming the object of that jnanam, that is drushyatvam. Drushyatvam, do you follow that word?
Yes.
Drushyatvam is to have the status of being the object of knowledge. to have the status of being the object of knowledge, that is drushikarmatvam. Drushikarmatva apattihi. Apatti means prapti. Apatti. Apatti, we have come across this word earlier also. Apatti means prapti. Drushikarmatva apatti means the status of being the object of, you can note down, the status of being the object of knowledge. Object of, say consciousness again. The status of being the object of knowledge, object of awareness. So that is the meaning. So drushikarmatva apatti nimittahi jagatah sarva pravruttihi. So what all activity takes place, it is taking place under the supervision of this consciousness only. Whatever activity you describe, all activity, they all become objects in the say act of knowing. So drushikarmatva. So that drushikarmatva, you again have, because you have noted down, you again think on it slowly. That meaning will say slowly sink into us, because this adhyaksha, this example again, we have to come back to the example of this light in a dark room. You say light a lamp in all the, in this dark room, all things are seen. So this lamp is adhyaksha. Lamp is something like the adhyaksha, and then or something like Surya. So the Surya, the sun shines equally on all objects. Similarly, the lamp shines equally on all objects, and then there is no such thing as good or bad in its light. It equally illuminates good, bad, everything. So similarly, all activities, they are activated. All activities which we have seen, somebody is eating, somebody is experiencing, somebody is seeing something, somebody is doing something else. So all these activities are illuminated and by this chetana only, and without this chetana nothing can happen. So in that sense only mayadhyakshena is being explained. Mayadhyakshena is the adhyakshatvam of Ishvara or the Brahman. The adhyakshatvam means, say, the presidency. Let us say the word, use the word presidency. The presidency of Ishvara is to be that illuminator, to be that something like light in a dark room. It is, he is just illuminating in his presence, all these things take place. So that is the meaning. Mayadhyakshena prakrutihi suyate. So all this thing, delicate thing is being, there is such a delicate balance is being explained, because Shankaracharya is going to write some more lines. That is because we have to see that Shankaracharya is answering to the contemporary critics. That we have to always keep in mind. Because somebody, a modern student, suddenly he takes up Shankaracharya Bhashyam and then reads. He may be a very brilliant man. I have come across very brilliant people taking up Shankara Bhashyam. They go to the Ramakrishna Math, take the Shankara Bhashyam and try to read. And then they have a feeling, Are Shankaracharya is talking in a very, very roundabout way, very, very devious manner. So that is what they say. So why? Because they don't understand the context. Every word he uses, every point he makes, he is to answer somebody else. He is either answering the Sankhyas, he is either answering the Mimamsaka, or he is answering the Bauddhas. Mostly these three people are talked about in Shankara Bhashyam, because at that time they were the three dominant schools. So here we are talking about this Prakriti and Purusha. The Sankhyas, in their philosophy also comes very, very close to this. That is the danger. He has to slightly distinguish it from that Sankhya philosophy, because Sankhya again is Dvaita. So there, Sankhya, I have noted down one Karika. There is a book called Sankhya Karika. Sankhya Karika, I have mentioned this book by one gentleman called Ishvara Krishna. Ishvara Krishna, he lived in some 1st century BC. So that Sankhya Karika, it was so famous at that time. It was such a dominant philosophy. Sankhya was a very dominant philosophy, and Ishvara Krishna was such a well-known philosopher of his time, that his books were translated into Tibetan and from Tibetan to Chinese and all that. That is the history of Sankhya Karika, a lot of Sankhya and Buddhist texts. Even prior to, in the 1st century AD and 1st century BC also, even at that time, they were translated into Tibetan and Chinese. Some of these books were reconstructed. Because some of these originals were lost, and then some books were reconstructed later in later dates. So anyway, there is one Karika which says the connection between the Prakriti and Purusha. He says this Prakriti is something like a dancer. It is something like a courtesan. And you are like, Purusha is like the king. You are the boss, and then you are going to a matinee, you are going to some show, and then in that show some girl comes and then dances and goes away. and then you enjoy and then come back. So that is the comparison given there in that Sankhya Karika to explain the relationship between the Prakriti and Purusha. The mantra, the shloka says, Rangasya Darshayitva Nivartate Nartaki Yatha Nrutyat. Rangasya Darshayitva, on that stage, Ranga means stage, on that Ranga, in that Rangam, Darshayitva, she manifests herself in all splendor, and then all these things, Sattva, Rajas, Tamo, Gunas, Mahat, Ahankara, all these beings and so many levels and so many layers of, say, Prakriti. So, like just as a dancer displays all her, say, skills on a stage, this Prakriti also displays all its grandeur on this stage. And then darshayitva nivartake nivartate nartaki yatha nrutyat nrutyat nivartate, then it goes back. So that means Prakriti goes into a sort of that pralaya, that laya they also accept. So they also accept the cycles of creation, Sankhya also. So there is a srushti and then there is a taking back. So this Prakriti is totally independent, it is independently creating and it is independently taking back. And then all this is happening for the benefit of this Purusha, who is something like some zamindar, who is some king, who is going and witnessing some dancing girl dancing. So rangasya darshayitva nivartate nartaki yatha nrutyat purushasya tatha atmanam prakashya vinivartate prakrutihi. Tatha atmanam prakashya, having displayed itself, the Prakriti vinivartate purushasya darshayitva, that is having shown, having displayed her dance before the Purusha, so the Prakriti withdraws. So that is what is that, this is the 59th karika. You can, if you want to look into that, this is the 59th karika of Ishvara Krishna's Sankhya karika. Even earlier also there is another karika which says purushasya darshanartham kaivalyartham tatha pradhanasya. There is another example given in that line. We need not go into all those details. So the basic point is, Shankaracharya is trying to, he is answering so many contemporary critics. So that we have to keep in mind. Otherwise, he need not use all this, Shastriya Paribhasha. So otherwise, he could have been very, very simple. He could have said, okay, there is Maya, there is Brahman. And then Brahman has nothing to do with this thing. Brahman, in that Brahman only all these things appears. So in that manner he can explain. But the doctrine is always assailed by various people. So when somebody assails your doctrine, you should be able to explain the postulation, whatever postulation you have made, you have to explain properly. So that is why all this logic goes on. So drushikarmatva patti, I try to explain whatever, have you followed to some extent? Drushikarmatva means drushyatvam. Drushyatvapatti, that is the status of becoming the object of knowledge. So all human activity comes under that. So that is the meaning. Simply speaking, all human activity is drushyam only. Drushyam, which is happening in the presence of that consciousness. So similarly, mayadhyakshena means the adhyakshatvam or presidency of Supreme Brahman is similar to that of a lamp in a dark room. He equally illuminates all things. So that is what we have to understand. So aham karishyami idam yasyami, all these things, avagati nishtaha avagatyavasana eva. So this line also you can see, avagati nishtaha, all these things are there taking place in say knowledge or consciousness. Avagati avasanaha, avagatyameva avasanaha, now avasanam yesham, that is all these things they are ending in this avagati, in this say consciousness only. So then yo asyadhyakshah parame vyoman, इत्यादयश्च मंत्राः एतमर्थं दर्शयन्ति. सो दिस मंत्र इज समवेयर फ्रॉम तैत्तिरीय ब्राह्मणम. द कोटेशन सेज यो अस्य अध्यक्षः परमे व्योमन, परम व्योम. बाय नाउ वी आर एक्सपर्ट्स, वी नो व्हाट इज दिस परम व्योमन, व्हाट इज दिस परमे व्योमन, द सुप्रीम आकाश. व्योम मीन्स आकाश. Vyomayanam vimanaha, vyomayanam vimanostri, you know that word vyoma means vimana, the space. What is that space? Hudayakasha. Exactly. Hudayakasha is the akasha. Hudaya means buddhi, that buddhi akasha. So we have now become experts. When we come across this word parame vyoman, you have to say that it is nothing but buddhi akasha. So this chaitanyam is at two levels. Strictly speaking, it is not at two levels, it appears at two levels. That is, one as Paramatma, one is that transcendental Chaitanya, and one which is appearing in this buddhi guha, one is reflected in this buddhi guha, this is this pratyagatma, let us say, that is the correct word also. So this paramatma at one level and pratyagatma, these again one and the same, because there cannot be any difference in chaitanya. There cannot be, that point also we discussed several times, there cannot be any distinction. Just now also we discussed there cannot be any difference in chaitanya. So this chaitanya, the difference will be in upadhi but not in chaitanya. So this yo asya adhyakshah paramevyoman yaha asya, asya means of this jagat. Adhyakshah, the one who is again the president, the overseer, the person who just untouched by everything, unaffected by anything, he is just illuminating all things equally. And then that man is Paramev Yoman, that particular entity is Paramev Yoman, means in that buddhi guha also. So that is what it is. Ityadayascha mantraha etamartham darshayanti, that means the same meaning which is discussed above is corroborated or supported by other mantras. That is what he says. Tatascha
ekasya devasya
sarvadhyakshabhuta
chaitanyamatrasya
paramarthatah sarvabhogan anabhisambandhinah
अन्यस्य चेतनांतरस्य अभावे
भोक्तुः अन्यस्य अभावात् किन्निमित्ता इयं सृष्टिः
इत्यत्र
प्रश्नप्रतिवचने अनुपपन्ने ओके सो नाउ ही इज मेकिंग अनदर पॉइंट सो ततः मीन्स बिकॉज ऑफ दिस While it is so, because he has explained over in all these above lines, that adhyaksha is something which is equally illuminating everything, and all human activity is an object. It is drushyatvam. All human activity can be categorized as drushyam, and that drushyatvam is there in all these things. So, and then this drushyatvam is again under the control of that druk only. When there is a druk, there is a drushyam. When there is no druk, there is no drushyam. सो एतमर्थं दर्शयन्ति ततश्च वैल इट इज सो एकस्य देवस्य देन वी आर सेइंग यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ओनली वन देव देन सर्वाध्यक्षभूत चैतन्यमात्रस्य यू आर आल्सो सेइंग दैट दिस जेंटलमैन दिस पर्टिकुलर एंटिटी इज सर्वाध्यक्षभूत चैतन्यमात्रम दिस इज ओनली प्योर कॉन्शियसनेस विच इज जस्ट अबव एवरीथिंग Pure consciousness which is above everything, not connected with anything, not connected with karma, not connected with karma phala and all these things. Then paramarthatah sarvabhogan abhisambandhinah, paramarthatah in reality, paramartha means in reality, sarvabhogan abhisambandhinah. So this is not having any type of contact or any type of connection with any type of bhoga or enjoyment. This bhoga comes only when that kartrutva bhavana is there. When there is no kartrutva bhavana, that bhoga. Bhoga comes from the word bhuj. Bhuj means to eat. Bhuj means to eat. From that word only, eat means not only eating, experiencing. Anything, I see something. So, that also is covered by the word bhuja, eating. I smell something, that also is covered by bhuj, enjoy. So, our experience, I may be happy or unhappy. Both the things are conveyed by the word bhuja. That is a bhoga. Sukha bhoga, it can be dukkha bhoga, it can be pleasant or unpleasant anyway. So this sarva bhoga anabhisambandhinaha, so there is no question of kartrutva in this thing. So there is no bhoga in the paramatma. Then anyasya chetanantarasya abhave, there is no other person also chetanantaraha. Suppose you are the father. Your son comes and then your son, you want to entertain your son and then you do some tricks and then you entertain your son. So like that, suppose you imagine Brahma and then somebody here and then for his entertainment, Brahma has to do all these things. So there is no such entity like that. Chetanantarasya abhava. There is only one Chaitanya, Kevala, Sakshi Cheta Kevalaha. That is only one non-dual thing. There is no other entity for whose benefit or for whose entertainment he has to enact all this drama. So all this, they say Jagat, which is a huge, great, splendid display of so many things, all these things, they need not be enacted for anybody else's entertainment. They are not being enacted for anybody else's entertainment. It is just an appearance, ultimately, that is the conclusion we will see. So, Chetanantarasya Abhave, Bhoktuhu Anyasya Abhavat. There is no other Bhokta. Bhoktuhu Anyasya Abhavat. Because of the absence of any other Bhokta. Bhokta means, again, Bhujidhatu only, enjoyer or experiencer. The only experiencer or the only thing which is illuminating everything is one and only one Chaitanya. There is no other Bhokta. So, all these words again, they are being told in order to counter the Sankhya argument. Just now I read out that line that Nartaki and Nartaki is displaying all these things. Like Nartaki, this Prakriti is displaying all its splendor for the benefit or for the enjoyment of Purusha. It's nothing like that. There is no such Purusha and Prakriti duality. That Purusha only is appearing. That is the Siddhanta in Vedanta. Bhoktu Hanyasya Abhavat. Kinnimitta iyam srushtihi ityatra, there can be some question. Then what is the reason? What is the motive? Kinnimitta, for what reason is this all this srushti? There is no other bhokta. You say that this sarvadhyaksha bhuta thing is only Chaitanya matra, pure consciousness, and he has no interest at all. Then he is also not connected by any experience, he is not enjoying, he is not having any connection with any of these karma phala. Then there is no other person also. Neither he is enjoying nor anybody else is enjoying. Isn't it? You followed it. Neither is he nor anybody else is enjoying. Then what for is this srushti? So that question will arise. That question is somebody can put. So he says, ityatra prashna prativachane anupapanne. This question should not arise. This question should not arise because all this thing is only an appearance. We say that all this thing is an appearance in that Brahman only. So that is why, for whose sake he is creating, for whose entertainment he is creating, all these questions will not arise. So that is the meaning. Anupapanna means inappropriate. Anupapanna. Because again he is quoting one Shruti. Ko Adha Veda. Kaiha Pravochat. Kuta Ajata. Kuta Iyam Visrushtihi. Ityadi Mantra Varnebhyaha. So this is from Ruk Samhita. It says, Ruk Samhita. Ko Adha Veda. Who has seen this? Who has directly known this? Kaha. Ko is Kaha. Adha. Adha means Sakshat. Sakshat, directly. Ko Adha Veda. Who has known it? Who has understood it? Who has known it directly? Kaiha pravochat. Who talked about it? Who can explain? The thing is, who can see it and who can explain it? So that is the meaning. Kaiha pravochat. Pravochat means who is the pravakta? Who is the person who is able to tell us? Who is able to explain to us? Kaiha pravochat. Kuta ajata. Kuta means from where? Or for what? Kuta means two things. From where and for what? For what? You know, from where it has come? Kuta ajata. That is, from where all this srushti has come? Kuta iyam visrushtihi. For what reason is this srushti? For what reason is all this srushti? That is, all this appearance. So, all these things, ityadi mantra varnebhya. So, all these things indicate that this srushti is something which is only an appearance. It is only an appearance, ko iddha veda, because nobody is able to say, it is totally anirvachaniyam. The doctrine in Vedanta is, we are neither totally negating nor totally accepting it as reality. We are not totally negating the world as totally unreal like the son of a barren woman. And we are not totally accepting it as absolute reality. Like, say, the materialists. Materialists say, yeah, this thing is very much there. Intelligence is something which is born out of that, matter only. So, that is what they say. But Vedanta says, it is the intelligence which alone is there, and matter is something which is appearing in that. So, kaiha pravochat, kuta ajata, kuta yam visrushtihi, ityadi mantra varnebhya. Then, darsitam cha bhagavata,
agnyanena avrutam jnanam,
tena muhyanti jantavaha, iti. So, this line we have seen earlier, In that shloka, 5th adhyaya, 15th shloka, he says, that is, what is that line? Nādatte kasyachit papam nashaiva sukurtam vibhuhu ajnane navrutam jnanam tena mukhyanti jantavah. That is the line. That is, nādatte kasyachit papam. This is, again, it is a very, very shocking statement for believers. For all the believers, it will be a shocking statement. Do you remember that line? Nādatte kasyachit papam. So, the Supreme Brahman or the Supreme Consciousness is something. He is not taking away your sins. Whereas religions normally say, oh my God, you come to my God, he will take away your sins and what not. But whereas Gita makes a very startling statement saying that Brahman is something which is totally above all these things, and then he is not there to take away your sins. He is not there to grant pardons. He is not there to accept your bribes. So he cannot be a party to all your activity. Every human being is responsible for his own action. Na adatte kasyachit papam na chaiva sukurtam vibhuhu. He does not either take away your papam or punyam. He is totally above all these things. Ajnanena avrutam jnanam tena mukhyanti jantavaha. Ajnanena avrutam. The whole thing is due to total misunderstanding. Whole thing is due to total misunderstanding. And then what all say God or you refer as somebody who will take away your sins is at a very lower level. That is something which is an appearance in that entity only. You are tentatively accepting it as a god. You are worshipping it. You are getting them some fruit. You worship that entity in whatever form you want or formless manner also. You accept any form, you go in, don't accept any form. But all that thing where you are doing with a dvaita buddhi. So religion is at a duality, at the level of duality only, isn't it? Religion is always at the level of duality. You go there, you worship the particular god, you pray, and then you want something. So that is it, isn't it? And then you want some heaven, you want to have some comforts, either in the other world or in this world. So this is all at the level of duality. So that is the thing which we have to see. Is there still time or?
3 minutes.
Okay. I think we'll finish it. Ajnanena avrutam jnanam tena mukhyanti jantavaha. All the jantavaha. Jantavaha means all the beings. All the beings. Mukhyanti. Mukhyanti means moham gachanti. Moham gachanti means they get deluded. They get deluded because they think that, oh, God is taking away my sins and what not. But then this, what we call the real absolute entity called Brahman, it is something which is above all these things. Then I think we will read the next shloka. Avajananti maam moodhah.
Avajananti maam moodhah.
Manushim tanumashritam.
Manushim tanumashritam.
Param bhava majanantah.
Param bhava majanantah.
Mama bhuta maheshwaram.
Mama bhuta maheshwaram.
So here again, he is coming talking about the way in which earlier in the fourth adhyaya we saw this aspect of avatara. Yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata, etc., etc., we saw. And then the concept of avatara also we saw. So whenever there is a crisis of dharma, then there is an appearance of that supreme Brahman in the form of a human being. So that he is referring to here. Maam moodaha manushim tanum ashritam manyante avajananti. All these people, maam, that is, when he refers to that maam, he is again referring to that supreme Brahman level only. All the people, they are thinking that I am just a body in this Krishna body. Krishna, Lord Krishna, they are thinking that it is only a body. But they are not able to realize that real nature of mind. That real nature is that Akhanda Chaitanya. This Akhanda Chaitanyam Sarvavyapi, that is his real nature. That Supreme Sat Chit Ananda, that is the real nature. They are not able to know my real nature. And then they are thinking that Manushim Tanum Ashritam. They are thinking that I have just taken up this body and I am an ordinary mortal. All the people, they are thinking that I am an ordinary mortal. They are not able to know my real nature. And then what are they doing? Avajananti. Avajananti means avagnya. Avagnya means indifference. Avagnya actually means indifference, just don't care attitude. Avajananti means they just dismiss me casually, they just take me very casually. they don't realize my real nature. So that is the meaning. Then parambhavam ajanantaha mama bhutamaheshwaram. Mama, my parambhavam, that is my supreme nature. Bhava is nature. My parambhavam is my supreme nature. Ajanantaha, not knowing my real nature. Mama bhutamaheshwaram. Mama bhutamaheshwaram parambhavam. Bhutamaheshwaram means Bhutanam Maheshwaratvam. That is the state of being the president, the state of being the adhyaksha of all these things. That adhyaksha, we saw that word just now. So, Mama Bhutamaheshwaram, this state of my presidency of over all the beings, that they do not understand. So, that is the general meaning of the shloka. We will see the bhashyam in the next class. The words are simple only. Mam Mudhaha Avajananti. All these people are mudhaha. Mudhaha means they are having a distorted vision. Mudha does not mean an idiot or fool or something like that. People who have a wrong vision. Mudhaha. It is from the same root moha. That is moha. Moha, muhya, muhyati, mudha. All these words are from the same root. That is people who have a deluded knowledge. They do have a lot of knowledge, but that is all deluded. Mudhaha. That is Viparita Jnana, all deluded persons. Mam Avajananti. Manushim Tanum Ashritam Manyante. Because they feel that I am just an ordinary human being. Then Mama Parambhava Majanantaha. They do not know my real supreme nature. So that is the general meaning of this shloka. We will see it in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Avashishyate. ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः